Plants consist of organs, tissues, and cells. Each of them has a specific structure that allows them to perform a particular set of functions that help the plant to survive. This video will cover plant organs and plant organ systems, also known as the root system and the shoot system. Okay, here we go. To begin, we should clarify what we generally mean when we refer to organ systems, organs, tissues, and cells. It's important to be familiar with these terms in order to understand how each structure contributes to the plant. A group of organs that work together is called an organ system. In humans, a familiar example might be the digestive system. In the digestive system, many organs work together to obtain energy from food. In plants, the so-called shoot system involves many structures like stems, branches, and leaves, which collaborate to allow the plant to harvest energy from the sun. Organs are a collection of tissues that form a unit with a specific function, for instance, the stomach in humans or a single leaf in a plant. Plants also contain specialized tissues and cells, but these will be covered in another video. Plants are multicellular eukaryotic organisms. Most survive by absorbing water and nutrients from their environment and by harnessing energy from the sun in a process known as photosynthesis. Plants are generally split into two major categories: non-vascular plants and vascular plants. Non-vascular plants, such as mosses, hornworts, and liverworts, do not have a system of xylem and phloem tubes to transport materials around the plant. Because they must rely on diffusion, these plants tend to be smaller and to have simpler tissues and structures. Many of these structures are only a few cells thick because diffusion can only occur effectively over very short distances. While they can sometimes have structures that somewhat resemble leaves, stems, or roots, they're not considered to be true leaves, stems, or roots because they lack these crucial transportation structures. This video will focus mainly on vascular plants and their specialized organs and organ systems. Vascular plants have two major organ systems, the root system and the shoot system. The root system is usually mostly underground. It supports the plant and absorbs water and minerals from the environment. The shoot system generally grows above ground, which allows some parts of it to absorb the light needed to perform photosynthesis. We'll now discuss each major organ system in detail, beginning with the root system. The roots have three major functions: anchoring the plant to the soil, absorbing water and minerals and transporting them upwards to the rest of the plant, and storing the products of photosynthesis. Some types of roots can also perform gas exchange, and a few types of plants have adventitious roots, which are at least partially above ground. The root system consists of primary, secondary, and sometimes even tertiary roots, in addition to root hairs, which help to increase their surface area. The last centimeter or so of the root is where cell division occurs. There are three major zones. The zone of cell division where new cells are formed, and if you've looked at onion root tips while studying mitosis in class, this is likely the area you observed. The zone of elongation, where the new cells stretch and increase in length, causing the root to get longer. And the zone of maturation, where cells specialize or differentiate into their unique roles. At the very end of the root is the root cap, which contains organelles that perceive gravity and allows the main root to grow down rather than at random. There are two major types of roots, tap roots and fibrous roots. Tap roots have one major root that grows straight down, sometimes with a few smaller branches protruding off of it. It looks a bit like a carrot. And in fact, carrots, beets, dandelions, parsnips, and jicama are all examples of taproot plants. Taproots are advantageous in dry environments because they can reach far down into the soil to reach water. Of course, this also makes them much harder to harvest or remove. For instance, think about how difficult it is to remove dandelions from your lawn. Typically, dicots have taproots, and some taproots, like those found in carrots, jicama, or beets, also function as a storage space for sugars and starches. Fibrous roots have a network of smaller roots that protrude outwards, usually at a much shallower level. These can be excellent at helping them to prevent soil erosion and are typical of monocots such as grasses. Now let's move on to the shoot system, which consists of stems, leaves, fruits, and flowers, or basically any structure that is not a root. Stems are part of the shoot system of the plant. They provide support and also connect the leaves, where photosynthesis occurs, with the roots, where some of the products are stored. Stems come in many shapes and sizes and can be soft, woody, branched, or unbranched. Stems also contain nodes, which are the attachment points for both leaves and flowers. The areas between the nodes are called internodes. Leaves are the major site of photosynthesis. Their cells contain chloroplasts, which harness energy from sunlight to produce sugars. Chlorophyll, the pigment inside the chloroplasts of the leaves, is what makes most leaves green. Leaves come in many shapes and sizes, each of which is specifically suited to its environment. For instance, plants in hot, dry environments often have spiky leaves or needles to help reduce water loss. In addition, some plants, such as succulents, store water in their leaf tissues. If you'd like a more detailed view of the interior structure of leaves, I've left a link in the video description. Flowers and/or fruits are related organs that are both part of the plant's reproductive system. The three female plant structures, the ovary, the style, and the stigma, are collectively known as the carpel. Flowers contain both male and female gametes, pollen and ovules respectively, but many plants can't self-fertilize. To get around this problem, some exchange gametes by attracting pollinators who will transfer pollen from one plant to another. Fruits are structures containing seeds, which form from the ovary at the base of the flower once it has been fertilized. Notice how the structures of fruits and flowers are quite similar. After the ovules are fertilized, the petals drop away and the ovary swells and grows into a fruit containing the seed or seeds. Apples, bell peppers, pea pods, cucumbers, eggplants, squashes, and more are technically all fruits. This is because they developed from the mature center of the flower. So, in summary, vascular plants have two major organ systems, the root system and the shoot system. Within each organ system, there are a number of useful structures that help the plant to absorb what it needs from its environment and/or to perform photosynthesis. If you found this video helpful, please consider subscribing to my channel and checking out some of my other videos. Thanks again for watching. See you next time.